I was waiting for a sign, running circles in the crowds. Clock started moving differently like a shift occurred. Whispers dripping in the distance like unintelligible utters from the abyss. It was darkness with a voice. It got close and then somehow behind me. In a place like this, shadows can be in two places at once, shifting shapes and filling voids as different states of matter. But what does it matter? Consciousness trembled and something deep began to stir. Leaking from the cage it was kept, slow electricity crept through the crevices and forgotten thoughts latched on to each spark. Through the darkness crawled an even darker thing, dragging itself through the recesses of the brain and oozing everything I worked so hard to ignore. It was a mirror forcing itself into the moment, the message chiseling its way into my attention. The madness has developed a life of its own. With it came its own ailments and preferences and mission, not to mention the ability to retain information. I sometimes feel like I'm only on the outside and that there's something deeper beneath me, myself that still is yet to be understood. I don't feel cohesive. The glue melts beneath the heat of pressure, trying to get it right. And in the midst of working hard to feel better, I get stuck asking questions, peering into the distance, problem-solving operations, pardon. I just need a moment to think. There is an art to staring at mountains, to relinquish your attention to absurdity, and realize that things of beauty exist with or without you. Surrender the ego and appreciate the opportunity. And achieve the peace for my energy.